Hey everyone, this is Nick, and I just wanted to jump on to respond to a quick viewer question on our video on how to add a line behind your bar chart. So this is for like benchmark lines, if you wanna add the line and put it behind the bar chart as opposed to in front of the bar chart. Check out that video, but Thom asked, what if the line needs to be going up and down? So I'm assuming that means, Thom, for like a horizontal bar chart instead of the vertical column chart that we made right here, the benchmark line is horizontal, and in your case, you want the benchmark line to be vertical. So I'm going to show you how you can do the same thing over here in Excel. Okay, so this is what it's going to look like. And the end, the vertical line right here is behind. And it's the exact same steps that you would follow for the column, but you just have to make a new custom angle for the drop shadow. So let's go ahead and move this out. I'll move this down here and we will insert. First, we're going to highlight our source data. We're going to insert a 2D bar chart right here. And I'm going to go ahead and move my title. I'm going to put the legend on the top. Let's just drag this a little bit more. Let's go up this way. You can do all the formatting that you want to do. Okay, so just like in the other video, we're gonna click on the data bar, not the line bar, but the bars that show our data. We're gonna put that on the secondary axis over here in the Format Data Series menu. And then we're gonna go ahead and delete one of the axes here. When you do that, it'll update appropriately. And now we have to go back to that chart options menu. We're going to click on the line bars. You can see now they're highlighted. And we're gonna click on the gap width and set that to 0. So now they come like this. On the drop shadow effect right here, we are going to create a drop shadow right here, just this outer one here. We're gonna set the transparency to 0, size is 100%, blur is going to be 0, and then the angle we're gonna bring all the way down to 0. All right, so the angle is gonna be 0, and I'm gonna make the distance 2, just so I can make the line a little bit thinner. And then we're gonna color this, we're gonna color that shadow orange so that it is the same color. And now one by one, I'm gonna isolate this one cell here. We're gonna click no fill. And remember, doing that one by one keeps the legend intact on the top if you wanna keep that. So you just have to go through and do that one by one. If you select no fill on all of them, then that legend item will go away. So there is your nice horizontal bar chart with the vertical benchmark line behind the bars. And if you want to, you can get rid of the axis there. You can go ahead and label, put direct labels on your data, everything that you would normally do to a chart. So Thom, I hope this helps. And if it does, let me know in the comments. Thanks so much for watching. See you guys next time.